in 1963, on the 25th of May, African leaders convened a summit meeting to found the Organization of African Unity. On this day, many African countries celebrate the hard-fought achievement of their freedom from European colonial powers. In Ghana, the day is marked as a public holiday, but here in Kenya, celebrations to mark the African Day were held at Karen Village, where our reporter Ken Kimani visited and filed the following report.
Today is a day where you celebrate the Afrocentric communities that are in any country in Africa. You celebrate arts, you celebrate the culture, you celebrate everything that Africa stands for.
African Day in Kenya, held at Karen Village, aimed at celebrating the African culture with exhibition of art, music, fashion and African cuisines. Exhibitors from different cultural backgrounds join hands to celebrate the event while showcasing the skills to preserve the African culture.
We do weaving, we do a carpet, wool. This is wool, this is the wool. We do spin it and then we make it to become the yarn. This is the dyed one. And this is the natural. This is the cotton. The cotton is a yarn. We do like we put a frame, and then we weave. These are the dyed one. This is the natural colors. This is the natural colors from the sheep, the wool.
Inspired by products with a lot of chemicals, Nubia Soap CEO Miss Kinuthia describes Nubia Soap as natural handcrafted soap made differently with products including rice, coffee, hibiscus and ginger.
Nubia Naturals, to describe it, it's basically handcrafted natural sattu. It is handcrafted in Kenya by Kenyans for Kenyans with love to the rest of the world. It's a brand that pays homage to the legacy that is Africa and all that. So we have a range of products. We have ginger root extract, we have rice, we have ginger and hibiscus, we have coffee. They're all 100% natural. You can use them on your face, on your body, and it lathers so well you can also use it on your hair.
However, Kinuthia explains that coffee soap is good for sensitive skin and works well to remove or conceal unpleasant smell in the body. The African Day brought together many people who had different opinions on why we celebrate the African Day. Cynthia Njora, an artist, says that the current art in Africa is a different art compared to the one was seen 10 years ago.
Africa Day, what roughly it presents is what, like, celebrating Africa as a people, the strides we have made so far and what we are yet to accomplish. I think in the art world, there is so much growth and also there is so much to do. You find what would have passed for art like 10 years ago is not the same thing as right now. Celebrate the arts, all its diversity, yes.
Dennis Choni, woodwork artist and a student at Kenyatta University, says that the African Day is a gift and should be celebrated by African despite age, color or tribe.
And it's quite an experience. Especially having an exhibition like this. The African Day tells us, it entails in contemporary African art, especially like this one that I did, which shows how African we are, our African taste, foods, dressings. The African Day, it's already a gift. We just have to enjoy and feel the Africanness in we.
However, challenges facing Africa are countries, as Africans has not yet united to make one Africa. Those who attended the event insisted that something should be done for Africans and especially for the African Day.
I don't think we are yet. I don't think we are yet because Africa is not. The mantra is Africa Moja, Africa Huru. So is Africa one yet? I don't think so. Is Africa free? Nah, I don't think so. So we are yet to get there.
Yet, but we definitely, the way we are celebrating is we are picking up the right things, but we haven't had a bigger audience for people to celebrate.
Oh, the African Day should be more celebrated around the world, I think, because not many people know there is something like Africa Day.
Or either NGOs that do love art, they will be able to sponsor this event, then we will celebrate it in a big festival, because Africa is amazing and it needs to be celebrated.
A quote from Gogi Wabiongo to Africa says that, and I quote, Africa needs back its economy, politics, culture, languages, and all patriotic writers.
Every 25th of May, we celebrate the African Day. This year, the Karen Village hosted residents and artists to celebrate the African Day, enhancing the African culture. Ken Kimani for KUTV, Arts and Traditions.